Welcome back to my channel, everyone, where I do tech reviews and talk about other tech-related things. And I thought it's such a nice day out that I go outside and film outside. Or as you can tell, I'm sitting in my car. And today I'll be talking about the Garmin 245 Music right here. And I've had this watch for about a month now, a little more. And I'll give you my initial thoughts about it, what I thought initially when I took it out of the box, and why I went for the 245 Music versus the 245. So initially when I wanted to buy this watch, the Forerunner 245 was $300 and the Forerunner 245 Music was $350. And I was waiting for that sale to happen. And I guess because of this whole pandemic, companies want to make some income. So they marked down their watches even though they're so new. So the new prices are $250 and $300 comparatively to for the Forerunner 245 and 245 Music. And I took advantage of that and got the 245 Music. And the reason I got it is because I pretty much bought the Music version for the same price as the 245 on its original price. So in my opinion, I pretty much just got Music for free. And I don't necessarily use Music, but if I ever need to, I can do that while my run or just walking around or anything else, and I pretty much got it for free, so I thought it was a great deal. So one thing I noticed about this watch right out of the box that no other reviewer mentioned was how responsive the buttons were. So they are responsive and they are great, and all of them work properly, except there is a little finicky thing with the down button. And it functioned, and yes, it's pressable and it's responsive, but you don't get that little snapback that you'd expect from it, like all the other buttons. It kind of gets stuck a little bit, and you don't hear that little pop sound every time you press it. And for me, that is a little annoying. And once I went through all the forums, I've noticed that everyone who's gotten this watch had the same complaint about the same button. So that means this is just a manufacturer issue. And it's not that the button breaks or anything. It is functional. You just don't get that satisfactory click back that you'd expect like on all the other Garmin watches. And initially bugged me a little bit, and it still from time to time bugs me, but I've kind of gotten over it. So just a note, if you're going to buy this watch and you're somebody who wants everything to be perfect, keep this in mind. Most of the down buttons on most of the watches seems like have that issue, that it doesn't feel that responsive snapback that you'd expect from other Garmin watches. So if you're somebody who's never had a Garmin watch, or you've had the very old school ones where it was very easy to navigate, the first thing I noticed when I got this smartwatch or fitness tracker was that it wasn't as easy to navigate as I thought. And I'm very versatile in all technology and all smartwatches and fitness tracker, but it took me a couple of days to get used to the 5-button layout. As you can see, it has 5 buttons. And so don't get discouraged by that. Initially, it'll be a little hard to get used to it, but once you get used to it, it is definitely easy to use, and that's one thing I noticed. And when I was buying this watch, I was debating this versus a touchscreen watch, and it was great, but the only thing you got to keep in mind, if you're doing a lot of sweating and a lot of workouts, the touchscreen is not going to work so well. That's why I went out for the 5-button layout. So for the price tag of $300 right now, which is on sale for the 245 Music, this watch comes with a lot of feature. And the first feature is, since it has the music, you can actually store up to 500 songs on this watch. And you can either use Spotify or Amazon Prime Music or any music that you physically have stored on your computer, you can physically put it on here. And the battery life with it is you can get 24 hours of GPS time, which I thought was ridiculous because that's running marathons on marathons. And it also has 7-day battery life. But if you were to use music and GPS at the same time, you get about 5 hours of total time, which if you were to still run a marathon and you would run under 5 hours, you could have music the whole way through and GPS tracking you while you're running it. So I'll be doing monthly, 3-month, 6-month updates on this watch, and to give you an update of how this watch is doing, how's the battery lasting, do I see any lag or difference in the watch over time, and just all the software updates that they keep doing, if it's actually making it better, worse, and so on. And to make sure to not miss that content, make sure to subscribe down below to my channel and smash that like button, because I'll be updating you monthly on how this watch is functioning over time. So most smartwatches and fitness trackers like the Garmin 245 Music are adding these features like heart rate, VO2 max, sleep tracking, stress tracking, water tracking, and whatever else that they're adding on to it is pretty much universal around all watches right now, and I think Garmin does a pretty good job about it. And even though this is not a touchscreen watch, you can still customize it any way you want. And on this watch, you can do all that, and there's a lot of customization that you can do on this watch that I can make a separate video. And if you're interested about that, make sure to comment down below and I'll make a separate video on how you can customize this watch and add all these cool features on it, and apps and widgets and watch faces. So just to give you a preview, one of the cool things I like about this is the watch faces, and the most favorite one I got so far is the Back to the Future. So if you can check, if you can kind of see right here, get a little glare, but it's a Back to the Future watch face, kind of like the movie in the car in the DeLorean. So I think that's pretty cool. But the most important feature that I think that the Garmin 245 Music has, and a lot of other Garmins have, is the live tracking feature and the assistant feature. So the live tracking feature is, once you set it up with a contact, like your parents or your friend, they can track you while you're running when you're using GPS, and that it can be used for safety reasons or just to make sure you're okay if you're just in a new place. And the same thing with the assistant feature slash help feature is that if you get lost or you fall or something and you can't get up and you need help and there's no one around, you can tap the assistant feature on your watch and it'll send a preset message to the preset contact or contacts that you set up with a message saying, hey, I need help, or hey, please get me. And it'll send it with the actual map of where you are, which I think is great. Just in case you get lost or you're not sure, or you start feeling afraid, you can contact for help. So while having this watch for a month, I think the GPS mode is great. It finds GPS instantly, at least where I am right now. There is no lag. You give it like 10-ish seconds and it picks up GPS. It is so visible under light. You don't even need to use the light button, but you can actually customize that to based off your wrist or based off the sunset. It'll turn on the light and so on. Battery life, I think, is great. I mostly use it for running now, and I usually wear it throughout the day. But if I were just to use it for runs, and I use about 40 minutes a run right now, 6 days a week, I get about 9 days of battery life, because I just have it only when I go running, which is above the 7 day battery life. I'm guessing if I were to wear it every day and have Bluetooth on and keep running every day, I'd probably get to 5-7 days. And it all depends on how you use it. But as a month in, I love this watch. It's working well and the battery life's great. And I'll keep you up to date over time how this watch is doing. So last thoughts is, I think that I made the right choice of grabbing that deal, getting the Garmin 245 Music on sale. And I think if you're interested about getting a Garmin and you were considering the same thing I was, which was 245 versus 245 Music, I'd say get the Music version, because it is still currently on sale. You can get it for a budget, and it's just a great deal and a great watch. And thank you guys for watching this video and my month review. And if you want to hear more, make sure to subscribe and check out my other content on the right. See you guys. Have a great day. Enjoy the sun and stay safe.